Dear Travis, I feel like such a coward writing this letter. After you left, I told Ryan everything. He yelled and cussed. He called me just about every name in the book. He stormed out and told me to go to hell. But in the morning, he came back. And he asked me to marry him. Got to thinking that life is held together by choices, one after the other. All shapes and sizes. Right or wrong doesn't matter, because life just keeps unfolding. I won't wait around for you. If you sit still, it could pass you by altogether.
Happy anniversary!
10 years? Hi.
Hi.
I guess I'd like to believe all those choices are made for us the instant we enter into this world. Because if that's true, then we're exactly where we're supposed to be. Forever.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Yeah, sure.
You seem like you're somewhere else tonight.
I know. I'm sorry. Just a little wiped out.
You'll never look at me the way you look at her. It's true. I know it. I'd hate her for it if I was one of those women, but I'm not.
Come on now.
Travis, I'm gonna give you some friendly advice. And then I'm gonna go home and cry, okay? Swallow your pride. You want to be the guy that shows up in 10 years with flowers in your hand, Moby by your side, hoping that she'll hear you out? Brian, she'll understand why you quit so easy. Because that's all any woman wants, is a man who's going to fight. So why don't you just do it now? Save yourself a whole decade. You know, she looks at you the same way.